everyone, welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. My name is Ashim Datta and today we are going to discuss about inductive transducer kit and its order code is BM2719. So in this video we are going to discuss about its working. So this is the LVDT kit for measurement of linear displacement. So here we are having IC, then this is the primary coil winding, then these are the secondary coil winding, then this is the digital indicator, then this is phase detector, then this is the main power on off switch, and this is the LED indication of the power switch. Then this is the amplitude port, this is the frequency port, and this is the connector for LVDT input, and we will use this connector to connect the input and we will perform the experiment. Now let's see the working of the kit. So for that, firstly we have to connect this connector at the LVDT input port like this, and now we will switch on the kit and we will use a DSO. Now we will connect the DSO across primary coil. So for that we will do the connections like this. So we have to connect the DSO across the primary coil like this, and we have to keep the amplitude port at maximum and we have to keep the frequency at 1k. So by using this port you can vary the frequency, and by using this port you can adjust the amplitude. So we have to keep the amplitude port at maximum, that is at fully clockwise position, and now we have to adjust the frequency around 1k. So now here on the DSO you can see that my frequency is around 1.01 kilohertz, and now I have to adjust the core position, this iron core position at the center. So for that, here you can see that on the millivolt display I am getting -10.5, so I have to keep it at 0. So for that I have to rotate it in clockwise direction so that I can get the reading at 0. So here you can see that on the display, on the 7 segment display, I am getting 0. So it means the soft iron core is at center position. Now I have to adjust this soft iron core position and I have to vary it by 1 mm distance, and I have to read the readings from here, and we will plot a table between this 1 mm distance and this millivolt reading, and we have to see the waveform position on the DSO. Now I am rotating it in clockwise direction so that it is giving positive values. So you can get the readings from here, and you have to shift this by 1 mm position. So here on the scale you can see the 1 mm position, so you have to move in steps of 1 mm and you have to check the readings here, and you can form the table between this millivolt and this mm distance, and that is how you can get the observations. You can also move it in negative, like an anti-clockwise direction, so you get the negative values at the millivolt. So that is how you can take both the readings and you can form the observation table. Now you can also observe the waveform on the secondary coil like this. So this is the waveform which we get on the secondary coil. Similarly you can connect it here and you can get the waveform here also. Like this. So the waveform will vary according to the millivolt values we are getting or the iron core position. Maybe it is at positive direction or at negative one. So all the waveforms and all the connections and all the operating procedure is mentioned in the manual. So you can observe the waveforms and cross check the waveforms from the manuals. So that is how you can perform this experiment. Now here you can see that we are getting positive values on the millivolt display. So we are getting this waveform on the secondary coil. Now when we take the readings at negative millivolt, so you can observe the changes on the amplitude of this waveform. So when I am rotating it in anti-clockwise direction, we can observe that the amplitude varies and the waveform is also changing its shape. Now we can also observe the waveform across this secondary coil. So at this secondary coil the waveform is different, and at this secondary coil the waveform position is different, and we are getting different waveforms at the negative part. Like here the amplitude is 1.4 volt, and when we keep it at positive one we are getting amplitude as 1.3 volt. So that is how this waveform changes. So you can observe the waveform at primary and both these secondary coils. So that is how you can perform this experiment, and you can get different readings of mm and mv, and you can plot the observation table between millivolt and mm. So that's all the demonstration from my side. If you have any query related to this kit, you can contact the Tesca Global website. You can find the link in the description. For more information, go through the manual. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, like, share and subscribe to our channel.